In this video lecture, we want to take a stab at coming up with a good working definition of what we mean when we say programming. Okay, let's get started. So what do we mean when we say programming? After all, here we are together in an introductory online programming concepts and methods class, but we haven't yet formally defined that term. In any field of study, it's important that we clearly define our terminology up front so that we're all working from a common understanding. Your prerequisite CS10 course probably talked about programming in a general sense. Most of us probably use computers and smartphones on a daily basis, so we're more than likely familiar with software from an end-user perspective. I'm sure we all have some nodding, heuristic understanding of programming, because otherwise none of us would even be involved with this online course, right? But is there some common, standard definition of programming we can draw upon? As it turns out, probably not. You'll find numerous definitions of programming depending upon the source you're using. But I think what you'll find is that most all of these definitions will use comparable words to dance around some common ideas. So what comes to mind when you think of programming? Here are a number of humorous stereotypes about programming and programmers. Do any of these images seem about right to you? Personally, I think there's some elements of truth in all of them. Here are a couple of examples. An earlier version of the CS10 textbook defines a programming language as a set of grammar rules, symbols, and special words used to construct a program, that is, to express a sequence of instructions for a computer, while a program is defined as a sequence of instructions written to perform a specified task. Wikipedia defines computer programming as the comprehensive process that leads from an original formulation of a computing problem to executable programs. The purpose of programming is to find a sequence of instructions that will automate performing a specific task or solve a given problem. And repeating the definition that I used in the last lecture segment, programming is the science or art of describing, in very specific terms, what you want done in such terms that the computer itself can understand and execute. So there are a couple different takes on defining programming, but I think you'll agree that in different words, they are all dancing around a similar set of ideas. So here are some common themes that seem to run throughout programming. Programming is all about using clear, logical thinking to solve some problem. Alongside that is the idea that programming is all about breaking up a big problem into smaller problems to solve. The ability to wield this kind of problem-solving skill is part of what makes computer science individuals so valuable in our modern economy, because hey, not everyone is able to do this. Programming has a lot to do with describing the solution to a problem in terms of precise, repeatable, step-by-step instructions, or what's referred to in CS as algorithms. Programming is about taking those instructions, or that algorithm, and being able to express it in the available syntax of some programming language, so that a computer can be instructed to solve that problem. Programming is actually part formal methodology and part creativity, some art and some science. Programming draws upon existing bodies of knowledge and lots of standard proven techniques to solve these problems. We might consider computer science as the formal embodiment of that knowledge. And finally, programming seeks to reuse as much as possible existing solutions and software components rather than starting from scratch and reinventing the wheel every time. This touches upon CS concepts such as software reuse or object orientation, or making use of what already exists to solve new problems. Here are some techniques of programming, general steps that we'll use this semester or that you will use as you hopefully move forward in computer science. Define your problem clearly. Identify up front what you know, what you don't know, and what exactly it is that you're trying to achieve. Divide and conquer. Break a large, complicated problem up into lots of smaller, simpler ones, which hopefully are easier problems to solve. Does a new problem resemble some familiar problem, or perhaps something we've already solved? If it's similar or even close, try transforming the new problem into an old one. Don't try to reinvent the wheel on every new problem. Instead, reuse past applicable solutions whenever possible. If you've got some code that already works, consider reusing it on a new problem. This is the idea of code reuse, and part of the beauty of object-oriented programming, where we can apply existing classes to new situations. And, if all else fails, use various of the above techniques in the creation of new approaches or algorithms to apply to new problems. Finally, in terms of programming terminology, you'll often hear certain terms used loosely or interchangeably. Just be aware that for our purposes in this class, the terms on the left and right are more or less interchangeable with the others on the same side. For example, for the end result of some programming, you might variously hear this referred to as programs, or software, or code, or applications, or apps. Similarly, for the process of creating that end result, we might refer to it in various contexts as programming, software development or software engineering, coding, writing code, or writing a program or application or app development. Again, in this course, we're not going to split hairs or semantics over these terminologies. While there are some subtle or implied degrees of meaning or quality between these various terms, you'll probably hear me referring to these things by various terms. And that won't be any great concern to us in this course. Okay, that's it for now. We'll next talk about the differences between various language types.